listen and learn.
Love to be happy.
That once was strong,
but you to be right.
Even that's turned wrong.
Time to change.
Hey, it's cool to look bummy and be a dumb dummy and disrespect your mommy.
Have you forgotten?
Who put you on this earth, huh?
Who put you on
earth? And who loved you since your birth? Reward is a brainwashed kid going wild. Young little girls already have a child.
Bad company.
Hey, now you've been framed.
Your parents have hurt you.
Hurted and ashamed.
For ruining yourself.
And your mommy can't cope. Hey, little kids, don't follow these dopes.
As a rule from a non-fool.
Your life don't drool. Don't be a fool like those that don't go to school.
Get ahead
and accomplish things. You'll see the wonder and the joy life brings.
Don't admire me.
Hey, they don't admire you. Their time's limited, hard rock too. So listen, be strong, scream whoopee-doo. Go for yours, cause dreams come true.
And you'll make your mommy
so proud of you too.
And this is the message
that the ruler Rick threw, and it's true.
You know what?
You're a disgust. You know someone that I can trust.
You'd steal my welfare.
And you'd run and buy some dust and
lunch, I must say.
Big shot, you're not. Your friends are talking and I'm hearing that your girls are what? You didn't know? Go steal and rob.
And while you're at it,
go get a suit for a job. You see, you're acting like this urge is demanding.
I'm always up.
Have some understanding. Society's a weak excuse for a man.
It's time for the
right. Now it's time to take the stand. Believe it or not, the Lord still shines on you. He
guides you.
And he watched you as you grew plus.
At the age of
a little child, that's true. But folks your age don't act like you do. So
be mature.
And put the boy to a home.
And if you're over 18,
I wish you'd act like an adult.
Don't live in a world
of hate, hate, hate.
Pull yourself together
and get yourself straight.
Men don't steal.
Hey, most don't borrow.
And if you smoke crack,
your kids will smoke crack tomorrow.
So be more mature. Make your own money.
Hey, be proud, that's yours.
You know why? Cause that's a man.
That brain's no spice.
Staying out of trouble
when it comes inside.
And a man never loses a fight.
In God's sight, cause righteous laws are overdue. And this is the message that the ruler Rick threw, and it's true.
You know what?
Good. It's your man MC Shan, and you tuned into the G-Lew Show, Flashback Fridays. Y'all already know what it is. One time for your mind, two times for your soul.
Hit this motherfucker, G.
No, man, I can't fuck with it right now.
Oh, man, I've been dealing with you for 3 motherfucking months. You ain't hit the pipe in front of me yet.
So what you saying?
Thank you, 5-0.
5-0? Man, I ain't no motherfucking cop.
Well, hit this motherfucker then.
Tonight, I get in some shit.
Yeah.
Deep trouble.
on the incognito tip. Killing motherfuckers if I have to. Filling gaps too. Let your niggas know I'm coming at you. I guess that's part of the game. But I feel for the nigga who think he just gon' come and jank things with the swiftness. So get it right with the quickness and let me handle my business. Yo, I'm on a mission and my mission won't stop until I get the nigga maxin' at the top.
I hope you get his ass before he drop.
Kingpin kicking back while his workers play his rock. Coming up like a fat rat. Big money, big car, big bodyguards on his back. So it's difficult to get.
But I got the hooker with somebody who knows how to get in contact with him.
Hit him like this and like that. Let him know that I'm looking for a big fat dope sack. What is the spin, so let's crush it. If you wanna handle it, tonight we'll discuss it. On a nigga's time and a nigga's place. Take my strap just in case one of his boys recognize my face. Cause he's a shiesty motherfucker. But I give the fuck, cause I'm going deep cover. Yeah, and you don't stop.
Cause it's 187 on an undercover car.
Yeah, and you don't stop.
Cause it's 187 on an undercover car. Creep with me as I crawl through the hood. Maniac lunatic calling Snoop Eastwood. Kicking dust as I bust fuck peace. And the motherfucking drunk police. You already know I give a fuck about a cop. So why in the fuck would you think that it would stop? Plot, yeah, that's what we's about to do. Take your ass on a mission with the boys in blue. Dre,
what up, Snoop?
Yo, I got the feeling. Tonight's the night like Betty Wright. And I'm chilling, killing, feeling. No remorse, yeah. So let's go straight to the motherfucking source and see what we can find. Crooked ass cops that be getting niggas a gang of time. And now they wanna make a deal with me. Scoop me up and put me on their team and chill with me. And make my pockets bigger. They wanna meet with me tonight at 7 o'clock.
So what's up, nigga?
What you wanna do?
What you wanna do?
I got the gauge of Uzi in my motherfucking 22. So if you wanna blast, nigga, we can buck them. If we sick them, then we suck them. So fuck.
And you don't stop.
Cause it's 187 on an undercover car.
Yeah, and you don't stop.
Cause it's 187 on an undercover car. 6:45 was the time on the clock when me and my homie bailed in the parking lot. The scene looked strange and it felt like a setup.
Bet not be, cause if it is, they get lit up.
Oh, here they come from the back and they lack. I'm checking for the gas they strap. So what's up, Black?
Chill, let's hit a deal. If it ain't up to what you feel, then grab your steel.
Right, so what you motherfuckers gon' come at me with? Hope you ain't wantin' none of my grip, cause you can say that shit.
Guess what they told me?
We give you 20 G's if you snitch on your homie. We'll put you in a home and make your life plush. Oh yeah, but you gotta sell dope for us. Let me think about it. Turn my back and grab my gat. And guess what I told you before I shot it?
If you don't quit, yeah. If you don't stop, yeah. I'm letting my gat.
Cause it's 187 on an undercover car.
Yeah, and you don't stop.
Cause it's 187 on an undercover car.
Yeah, and you don't stop.
Cause it's 187 on an undercover car.
Yeah, and you don't stop.
Cause it's 187 on an undercover car.
Yeah, and you don't stop.
Cause it's 187 on an undercover car.
Yeah, and you don't stop.
Cause it's 187 on an undercover car.
Yes, yes, yes. Welcome to the G-Lew Show. Fabulous Flashback Fridays. You know, welcome everybody to the show. You already know we got a good episode lined up tonight. We only do legends on Flashback Fridays. Tonight ain't no different. We got MC Shan, original Queensbridge native. Put Queensbridge on the map. Along with Marley Marl, the whole Juice crew. We got legendary shit going on tonight. Shannon's going to be checking in shortly, you know, so in the meantime, between time, I'm going to play some Flashback hip-hop classics for you tonight. You can call in if you need to. Call the numbers the same as it always is, 914-803-4001. Shout out to my loyal listeners, subscribers. Make sure you hit that subscribe button on YouTube if you're listening. Blog Talk Radio, hit the follow button, hit the like button. Like, share, and subscribe the episode, the show, the movement. So we can get it up there, man. Trying to get some sponsors up, you dig? Shout out to the Reverend Ali. Shout out to Miss Jane up in Washington. Shout out to Miss Jean. Shout out to my homeboy Jeff Kwan, BTP Media Group, the plug, makes it all happen. Shout out to Jeff out there. Shout out to my homeboy B12. Just had him on the show this Wednesday night. That was a classic episode. Shout out to the whole Bay Area, man, showing me much love. Shout out to Pete Cola. Shout out to Los Angeles, California. Shout out to the ATL. All surrounding areas listening in. This is the G-Lew Show, Flashback Fridays. But we do it majorly, man. You know what I'm saying? Once again, the calling number is 914-803-4001. Drop a line or two. Speak, I speak back. Shout out to all the ladies, the homies. My guest tonight, MC Shan. Man, it's just going to be a great episode. I can't wait to chop it up with Shan. I got so much to talk about, so many questions. You know, first, I'm a fan, first and foremost. But, you know, Shan was one of the first ones to do it major. You know, definitely put Queensbridge on the map. If you know about cats like Nas, Noriega, Capone, CNN, Mobb Deep, you know, Roxanne, Shante, you know what I'm saying? The list goes on and on. Tragedy, Gaddafi, you know, if you know about these cats, man, they came from Queensbridge, and MC Shan was definitely the first to do it, put it out there, paved the way for the rest of the crew, man, the Juice crew. Like I said, Mobb Deep, Nas, you know, a lot of people came out of Queensbridge, man, so I'm going to show love to Queensbridge tonight. My special guest, MC Shan, the original Juice crew member. Hopefully we can get Marley Marr to call in too. Maybe that'll happen, you dig? But yeah, in the meantime, between time, you know the number, you know the name, you know the place. It's the G-Lew Show, where we all up in your face with much bass. Let me take it back like this right here, man. Let me see what you know about this. This small boy Ali.
Rock.
Good, it's your man MC Shan, and you tuned into the G-Lew Show, Flashback Fridays. Y'all already know what it is, one time for your mind, two times for your soul.
Hey, yo, hold up, we're doing this for the bridge, we don't need that tonight, ain't gonna be none of that tonight, yo, we're doing this for the bridge.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got Queens responding up in this motherfucker tonight. They just came from war. They will let you know a little something about where they come from.
You love to hear the story again and again about a rap dynasty that just won't end. The monument still in your face. Niggas played out, Shan still in the place. Hip hop sat out in the dark. The bridge was never over. We left our mark.
Know somebody with strength. You know the drill. Shit was real. Fuck around, got killed. You know the hill breeded thugs. Death to those who squill. Squeezing them slugs. One love to those that died in the field. So many names, don't got room to spit them. But through my rhymes, they live it. Breed the bridge, through tracks I'm giving. Never lose sight. 41st side's my life. The 40th side of life. Son, we keeping it tight.
Yo, it ain't just the music. Poop aspirations or ghetto illusions. It's the pride of East Side and all the beautiful children and unleashed dreams coming through each building. If you sleep, you better wake up. As you see, mega more mature. I'm on a record with nature. Mine on my paper, nine on my waist. There's no denying the greatness. Queensbridge, never try to disgrace it.
Ayo, the Queensbridge Association breeds similarity. Bricked up, chipped off, rocked out, salaries. Pull out, long guns, pop out, have your teeth. Like I gotta see a thug, nigga, ill as me. The ill winning me, I rep that willingly. Step back, enemy, step past, enemy. Yeah. Six blocks, losing my mind. Running from D's, these P's got me using my nine. I pop four.
Y'all know the place where stars is from. Every night it sparks off and the crowds are run. We leave chicks tripping over strollers. Slipping sober. In Queens, you be the victim till you get to know us. Your hood's bogus. My hood be keeping it crunk. So much be jumping off, I ain't sleeping a month. Y'all can play the front line, I'll be deep in the cut. Drive through, y'all can't peep it enough. You in the
bridge,
nigga.
You must pay homage to my projects. Be thorough to the end. Only jail and death divided. From rap to the crack supplies. Out of town and get knocked off. We regulate block laws. I had the hood like watch. Federal cop force, QB to the cracks in the pavement. Mr. Everything to recenter, pool for stacks in the basement. Niggas understand the drama we bring. The legacy dynasty of holding the ring. We QB king.
For you, I take a fifth to the head until I hurl boomerang done. QB bust a gun. Keep them PC niggas on the run. One, Mati specialist. 2-5, the nemesis. The last verse, C-O-N-Y, remember this. Resurrect you, the birth of my seed. Crime genetic. You synthetic. Your gangsters cosmetic. I move niggas telekinetic. Yo, who wanna set it?
Move. Me and my dogs coming through. We the grand. Go against us. You feel pain. Get ranked on. We beat niggas numb. These niggas are dumb. You can't resist my guns. 2001, we still thump. The fuck happened to y'all? We like that snowball going downhill. We get large, you get bullets lodged in your jaw, your ribs, your arms. We party hard at the bar, buying bottles of overpriced styles and Remy Ma. The head niggas in charge. We number one, QB, there's no competition. Infamous records, bars and hooks, listen. Little Snorty Mega, we independent. Done, we infamous, Marvin, Gardnitty, and Twin.
Satan, the ill will brave hearts, L.E.S.
Yo,
millennium.
No faces, fofo blazes, no one's safe. It's music mogul rolling with 100 soldiers, gangsters we postal. Oh, you didn't want to know whose life was written. The life I'm living, the ice of women, the kites descending to life forbidden. The streets to prison, I touch you, then buck you. Heats be spitting, laser, AR-15, doors come down. Jaws is broke, your whole crew's coughing bound. Your hoe, your man, lieutenant, your boss get found. This dough I got, I spin it and toss around. New York, it's time we flip it, where you from? Ladies, it's time we flip it, where you from? Now tell me, who was the true thugs in videos first? Who had the project behind us? Who bid it the worst? We from the largest project, yo, the biggest on earth. Queensbridge, yo, the history left y'all cursed because
keep on rocking the bridge, or keep rocking if the beat stop rocking the bridge, or keep rocking. Keep on rocking the bridge, or keep rocking if the beat stop rocking the bridge, or keep rocking. Keep on rocking the bridge, or keep rocking if the beat stop rocking the bridge, or keep rocking.
Flashback Friday, the G-Lew Show. Queensbridge is in the house tonight. We got the legendary MC Shan, man, from the Juice Crew, joining us real shortly. So everybody tune in. Tell a friend it's going down. It's the G-Lew Show. Phone lines are open. Call us out there if you want to speak. I see the phone lines lit up already. Shout out to my peoples tuning in tonight. We got a monumental classic episode tonight. Trust me when I tell you this. MC Shan, homie, has a lot to talk about. He's a pioneer. Started off the Queensbridge movement. You heard the Nas, like I said, all these rappers, Mobb Deep. You know, MC Shan was the first, one of the first to come from Queensbridge along with Marley Marl to do it and set history and precedent in hip-hop. So we have the legend on the show tonight. Once again, shout out to my sponsors, BTP Media Group, Jeff Kwan, 93.3 FM-ism. Hope you tuned in last night. We had the legendary Lennox, man, Mr. Rankin, live on 93.3. If you missed that, go back and check it out on Blog Talk Radio. It was classic. Shout out to my listeners and callers, my folks, my family, my people. You know, Miss Jean, what's up, baby? Shout out to my bro CeeLo tapping in with us. So many to name. Shout out to Ali. Shout out to my boy Snow. What up, Snow? I got something for you, homie. Let's go get it. Flashback Friday.
What's up, homie? It's a homie.
Got beef, what a pity. Back for the payback, black, it came up shoulder. Jay, your ass is out, eight rotor. Another funky rap about your jealous conflict. How you diss CMW, boy, you ain't said shit. Your senses should tell you, kick it, don't be a hero. Equip the whip, it's eight, unlike a zero. I gotta hit ya, or get with ya. Sit down, clown, I commit to paint a picture. It's kinda funny, but yet somewhat amazing. Take you serious, I think about it while I'm blazing. Only then will my reactions show how I chill and let my tempo flow. Sorry is the name for your rap, no competition. Dissing, boy, you need to be slapped. Eight ain't no punk, so learn it quick. Oh yes, P.S., CMW, and you can get my duck stick. Duck stick. You can get my duck stick. I don't believe it. How the hell'd you get on wax? Making demos on your tape deck tracks. You did a show, and I heard it was whack. You tossed out records, they got tossed right back. You got the nerve trying to go down like a trooper. And better worse, you go down like King Cooper. So stop your little dissing, saying that I can handle. I put your lights out, you have to rap by candle. Go ahead up, punk, or sell out. I know you must have heard the word New Jack. I'm not a buster, always down to bust a record. I party, know what I mean? But unlike yourself, sucker, I do it for green. So period, end of story, don't even pour me. The chill MC claim the glory. So that's it, the eight and chill is the shit. Chill, word, and you can get the duck sick. Duck sick, duck sick. Duck sick, duck sick. Chill, get the duck sick. Get the duck sick. Wait a minute, wait a minute. Hold up, homie, I know you're kidding. Saying he can't hang your bullshit. I'm not a rookie, meaning a beginner. If faking was a sin, you'd be a sinner. Load up my mic and yak and start gunning. Fresh off the Compton streets, so start running. You come across like a two-bit sucker, trying to compare with a hard motherfucker. Punk, they call me give me respect. I heard you did a show on your mom's tape deck. Fool, you fucked up smooth trying to diss a victim of a violent crime on a list. So wake up and smell the blood, little pupils. Trying to go head up, punk, you got no scruples. Conflict, you're big, you're sick. You can't fade us, but yo, you can get the ease up sick. You can get the ease up sick. School now. You got your hip to be a rapper. You're sorry, jackass. You punk with a snapper. Just take a step back and boy, start peeping. Oh, Nate, chill. She ain't no sleeping. Quiet, it just kept the news spread like A's. Hip hop, CMW gets paid. Always down to dunk the funk. I'm clowning down. A weak ass punk. The beef you got, the chill don't mean shit. Just a test I have to pass to show I'm on hit. And the chills on hit legit. With the E, I don't quit, quit. I grab a chair and a whip like a lion sucker. I'm taming, peel a cap and snap on the mic because I'm gaming. So watch me rip, cause your suckers is on the ego tip. Stupid suckers. Yo, you can get chills, duck sick. What you say, E? Get the duck sick. Yo, who wants the duck sick, man? My man unknown, man, unknown. My man DJ Slim, boy, Slim. Word him up, Mike, we be booing on the boys. Who wants the duck sick? My DJ, MC, and my team. My duck sick, duck sick, duck sick.
You guys are sick.
Flashback Fridays, the G-Lew Show. Shout out to my folks in Compton. Shout out to Melly Mel, my homeboy gangster out there, man, doing their thing. It's the G-Lew Show. Shout out to Kev Mac Videos as well, my sponsor. Also, Black Box Productions. Also, we got a flashback alert. In 2 weeks coming right here on the G-Lew Show, we got Seattle in the house. I'm going to give you the Seattle history, hip-hop history. We got the legendary Kid Sensation. Mix-A-Lot may check in as well, but we got the Seattle car, the homeboy as well. I forgot my DJ's name, but we're going to get the Seattle history not next week. We'll be coming back with TNT next week. You know, shout out to Tammy and Terry. In 2 weeks, we got the legendary Kid Sensation, the Mix-A-Lot crew, live on Flashback Fridays, man. So you better tune in or hear about it later.
You are. What's the deal, y'all? This is the legendary Hall of Fame DJ Mixmaster Ice from UTFO. And you are now tuned into the GU Show on Flashback.
Brothers and sisters, brothers and sisters, I don't know what this world is coming to.
Yes, the rhythm's a rebel. Without a pause, I'm lowering my level. The hard drama, where you never been, I'm in. You want styling, you know it's time again. See, the enemy telling you to hear it. They praise the music, it's time to play the lyrics. Some say no to the album, the show. Bum rush the sound. No, you guess I'm just a radical, not on sabbatical, yes, to make it critical. The only part of your body should be part of it too. Pass the power on the hour from the rebel to you.
Hey, yo, Chuck, man, I don't understand this, man. Yo, you got to slow down, man, you're losing them.
Radio, suckers never play me. All the mix, they just don't hear me now. Knowing and growing, when they're clocking my throne, it's no thinking and taking everything that a brother owns. The president pulling out my ray gun. That's the next one. I could be a showgun.
back one more time.
Bring that beat back,
bring
man.
Bring that beat back. Bring the beat back.
Y'all want to hear that beat, right? Bring that beat back.
Bring that
one,
beat back.
1, 2, 3, 4, hit it.
It's the legendary Flashback Fridays. You know what it is, the G-Lew Show. Shout out to Miss Melody tuning in, man, the lovely wife of my homeboy Snow. I heard she's listening. You know she's from New York, so sure you can appreciate this show. We got your boy MC Shan from Queensbridge on here tonight. Shout out to Miss Pamela, aka DD Harrison, tuning in from LA. What's up, baby? Who else is out there? Shout out to my homeboy Soldier Chalk, man, behind them walls, man. He got his own show going on tonight, man. Show you some support and love, bro. So holla at my homeboy Chalk, man, aka Terry from TNT. He'll be back on next Friday night with me live, talking relationship talk. You know, we get deep, we get sensitive, people catch feelings, all that shit, man. But it's all love. You dig? We're gonna give you some real talk, some real advice. Tweeds on that show too. Giving some cupcake advice. Shout out to the cupcakers out there. Snow. You know, all my homies, they know who they are. Shout out to the cupcakers as well, man. But it's the G-Lew Show. You know, MC Shan will be checking in with us shortly, so I'm gonna play some more music in the meantime. Between time, the call-in number is 914-803-4001. Shout out to my boy Hanks, the gangster out there, man. He's gonna check in with me shortly. Got some updates to give you, some news about Sunday's show. We got a big show coming up this Sunday, OG Sundays. We got Dr. Ism back, you know, so tune in. We got some updates on that coming up. Flashback Fridays.
We are firing up the turntable and dusting off the classics. Here comes another Flashback.
A lot of things changed. She started acting funny. I mean, like a bitch train. We had little squabbles, arguments, fights, watch stories in the day. Stayed out night. I say, baby, where you been for all that time? She cuddled me close and say that I be the one that she called her only, but she ran with another man and left me lonely.
Girl, why'd you have to leave that way? I love you to this day, and it hurts to think of the words you used to say.
She put it to me plain, couldn't put it no clearer. Lipstick written on the bedroom mirror, said I'm leaving you now, and I know that you miss me. You're probably saying, damn man, why she diss me, but you see, but I felt that it was time to go. Then I packed my bags and I'm leaving, so you take care, and I hope you live long, and don't worry, cause there's nothing that you did wrong. You'll find the right girl, someday you'll see, but I'm the type of woman that must be three. I said, why me? And fell to the bed, reached for the nine and put it to my head, and thought about the words that she once said.
Shan, you know that you're my one and only,
but she ran with another man and left me lonely.
Or just have a seat and listen to the way in what I am slaying, a different kind of rapper language that I am saying. To all the party people that ignore the info, when it comes to rocking parties, I am a info maniac, brainiac for doing my dancing. My record make the music, we'll put you in a trance and hypnotize your body and like it's a cardigan. You won't be fighting the ill and you just be partying down with the funky town with yours truly. Original B-I-V, I mean, okay, I was the E, and I came to have fun and not be number one, and just here to let you know who's like running the place, and everywhere that I perform and do a show, as long as you know that.
Nobody beats the biz.
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 Yeah, the B-I-C-M-A-R-K-I-E-N. I go for what I know, do when they show for human beings. I'm guaranteed to rock to make the ladies scream and shout. I'm bound to wreck your body as they turn the party out. The Marty rapper, no chapper, always have a fawn. And when you hear the Biz Markie, I get the jaw done. Yes, I'm the M-A-R-K-I-E-N, though that's me. I got the stutter step to keep it check. My speed is so unique. They say I look and sound funny, but I don't be caring. I rock the Latin Quarter, rooftop, being sweat and Roseland. The Hawthorne, Madison Square Garden, even I put a word fit at Jaffa Center. Part in the way that I'll be talking about the places I be rocking. I love to perform for the people that be clocking. I think that your own mind on it like I want it, but you pay for a good performance. Look on it, you want it. That's why I'm here to be like letting you know that I'm a highly recognized as the king of disco, making people laugh and have a lot of enjoyment. I'm the best person for this type of employment. That's why. Coupon, I catch a sale retail before it gets stale. So hurry up and get the wick, check out the mail and shop nonstop. But how I hip hop on the mic and like make you cooperate with the rhythm. That is what I give them. Reagan is depressed, but I voted for Shirley Chisholm. It might sound confusing, the style that I'm using, but in the end, I'm sure that you will find it quite amusing and funny. Oh, honey, it's just ridiculous. Don't try to front. Come on and admit you was thrilled, chilled. Your heart was fulfilled, so respect the architect as I begin to build. Science and my reliance is upon my rap. Like Carl Lewis, I get to it, so let's go to lap.
Nobody beats the best.
Nobody beats the
best.
Nobody beats the best.
Nobody beats the best.
Nobody beats the best. Nobody beats the best.
Raging the best that you've become. Every day of my life I take a glimpse in the mirror and I see motherfuckers trying to be like me. Every time I put it down with a D on me.
Homie at the mouth and wagging his tail, searching through the yard with a keen sense of smell, looking for the business in the heat. And when he finds her, he'll be slipping her seat. We travel in packs and we do it from the back. How else can you get to the booty? We do it doggy style. All the while we do it doggy style. Yo, motherfucking ho! He fucked the fleas off the bitch. He shake the ticks off his dick. And in a booty, he buries his motherfucking bone. And if there's any leftover, he roll over and take a doggy bag home.
Damn, that Tangeray is talking to a nigga.
I ain't bullshit. What
are
y'all
doing? I got pissed.
Hey, 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 it's Flashback Friday. Shout out to my boy Woody tuning in from Brick City. What's up, homie? It's going out to you. Flashback. MC Shan coming up in a few minutes.
Why you gotta tell Mickey everything about us?
Because I needed somebody to talk to.
But you trying to make it seem like I started it.
I just told the story the way it went.
Michelle.
What?
Look, since you seem to be forgetting, I'm gonna tell y'all what started from the beginning, alright?
Mm-hmm.
Cruising down the Ave with my homeboy Boo, laying back like Jack Mellor went to the groove. The greatest man alive was cold rock in my world. Been a rock a little harder when I thought it was fresh black girl. But hold up, I can't go out like it's nothing. I had to conjure up a cool way to stress. They call me ES, the overlord of fresh. I saw you in the dress and I just had to progress. My compliment came through in the clutch. She started to blush, then I knew what was up. Called the next morning, said, what'll it be? Then I end the movie or just chilling with me. She said, me. So I went and got the Slimmy. As soon as I opened the door, she said, Jimmy. It was like I was a bone and she was fetching. She got what cold swallowed my one like me, Gretchen. Then after a couple weeks of good love of my friend, she did the dummy move. Come around the corner looking funky fresh. This new Jack Bae started popping a mess. Steady tripping, cause I ain't calling last night. I kindly pulled it to the side and said, yo, take a hike, cause I don't need it, girl. Too many problems in this world. So boo boo on the head with your Jerry girl. She went to Jefferson's and Lincoln. I said, no way, no slump. What do you think this is, President's Day? People start bugging over things like that, honey. You know the time, so don't act funny with the money. I refuse to abuse my savings alone. So if you want some ends, baby, best go with your own. Now I said it was before and I'ma say it again. Let's believe you won't receive no forgiveness. Michelle, how come every time we argue it always gotta be about money?
When I was with Steady B, I had it all. Gucci, Louis Vuitton, gold, Liz Claiborne, I had it all. You ain't giving me nothing.
It's a shame nowadays. Got to stay paid. It ain't like the old days when you were serenade, take walks with your girl at night in the park and in the shadow. She could leave still her heart, but the new wave 80s has everything reversible. Instead of walks, you drive a Cadillac convertible. Two's bound to kill you. All you need is one to constantly bug you to get her hair done. Every week's a new style. She's always got the rocker like a Super Bowl sack. She's tackling your pockets, and when you wanna chill, you find that something always blocks it. You're looking for your wallet, but your girlfriend's got it. I tried to put your D. With my friend, you didn't listen. I should got you for your dividends.
You bought another dress? This is ridiculous.
The third dress.
The world is very different now. The world is very different now.
No, I don't like to get upset and I don't like to riff. But one thing that gets me hype is when girls shoot the gift. Now there's a little thing about the J-O-B, but what she's really trying to do is take the D-O-E and wreck your whole check on the latest design. When you're broke, it's all a joke, but when you're paid, it's fine. This advice to you, I'll lend. Begin to let it sink and you can spend, but don't get taken under, my friend. Now I said it once before and I'ma say it again. Let's believe you won't receive no dividends. Now I said it once before and I'ma say it again. Let's believe you won't receive no dividends.
What?
You know what I'm saying? I don't mind giving my girl something, or any woman for that matter, if they need it. But love shouldn't be used as a personal visa card on the strip. It's the same way you trying to get somebody, you can be got. Murphy's Law is still in effect. Ain't that right, Wood?
Yes, yes, yes.
Why are you looking at me like that, E.S.?
Because, man, Michelle, if I knew you was going through me like this, I wouldn't have never stepped to you from the video.
If I knew you wasn't going to provide for me, I wouldn't have talked to you anyway, straight up. I thought you was the greatest man alive, but I guess I was wrong.
I wonder if my grandpa and pop would do things like this back in the day. Cause man, this ain't worth it.
The world
It's a cold game, man. It's out to three times dope.
The world is very different now.
Philly, Philly, Philadelphia. What up to my boy Ali? North Philly, South Philly, stand up. It's the G-Lew Show Flashback Fridays. And this right here is out the request line. My homeboy D wanted to hear this because he said he's cool like that. I'm sending this one out to Miss Jean as well because you're cool like that as well, Queen. It's Flashback Fridays. MC Shan, top of the hour. Let's roll.
But
Cleopatra Jones.
And I'm chill like that. 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 I'm chill.
And a question. Us cause a buzz when a nickel bets a dope. Him, that's my man with the asteroid belt. They catch a fizz from the Mr. Doodle Pig. He rocks a tweet from the Brooklyn Nine Pig. The reverbs are slick like my gangster stroll. The lyrics just like Luke coming stacks and rolls. You used to find the bug in a box of babes. Now he boogies up your stage, plats twist the braids. And I'm peace like that. 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 Check it out, man. I groove like that. I'm smooth like that. I jive like that. I roll like that.
Yeah, I'm thick like that. I stack like that. I'm down like that. I'm black like that.
Yo, I funk like that. I'm fat like that. I'm in like that because I swing like that. We jazz like that. We freak like that. We zoom like that. We out. We out.
We out.
We out.
Flashback Friday. What up? Legendary, legendary show tonight. Flashback Fridays, man. Proud to be sitting in this seat tonight, getting ready to interview one of the legends in hip-hop. You know, one of my legends I looked up to, you know, Queensbridge native legend, MC Shan, Kill That Noise, The Bridge, Left You So Lonely, you know, started the Juice Crew with Marley Marl, you know, birth MCs like Nas, you know, the list goes on and on. He's coming up. top of the hour. It's all about MC Shan, man. So let's get into some classic Shan and come back with my special guest. Flashback Fridays, the G-Lew Show. Sponsored by PTP. Yeah. Flashback Friday, MC Shan, the legendary MC Shan. Shout out to Paramount. We got Paramount tapping in with us. What up to homie Roy Paramount. Check this out. MC Shan just pulled up. He's going to be coming up in a minute, right? So I'm going to do this right here, and we'll be right back. You can kill that noise.
Warning. 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 Devastating to your ear.
Rhyming is a thing that I do at will. Be glad to rock a party just to prove my skill. J-U-I-T is what I'm gaining with the style so fresh that is self-explaining. Never write a rhyme, I don't live that way. But when I get this, violators pay. I'm a crowd motivator, a sea annihilator. Never front the moves cause I'm not a perpetrator. I don't really mind being criticized for those who try to make fame or my name.
Devastating to your ear.
I devastate the crowd while the record spins. So called competitors have no win. I laugh at MCs who call me whack. You ordered, and now I'm gonna serve you, Jack. We're respected by all, treated just like kings. How could you have the nerve to say such things? If you knew at the time what you were saying, you wouldn't be on your knees.
Music.
Come on out.
Hey, the homie Snow said, Shan was banging on niggas before banging was done, man. Shout out to MC Shan. Definitely a legend. Wasn't biting his tongue for nothing. KRS-One did his thing. It was a legend. Dairy, first, some of the first disses on Wax. The Bridge, and then The Bridges Over South Bronx. Shout out to KRS-One, BDP. Rest in peace, Scholar Rock. You know, but it's all about my guest tonight, MC Shan. Straight out of Queensbridge Housing Projects, the largest projects in the world, I'm told. You know what I mean? Birth legends from there. So MC Shan is up next. Flashback Friday's the G-Lew Show, where we do it at.
Most attempt and the least that scored. See, I'm a rhyme right, I'm Marley Mixes my cut. I adore fly girls and I spit on sluts. I hold the rap population in the palm of my hand. Little children saying, "Ma, I wanna be like Shan." I got the knowledge to know, the wisdom to speak, the understanding of my rhymes is at its fullest peak. There were a lot of MCs that tried to rip, but they wound up on the slabs as an MC. Stick a typographical error. God bless the dead. Don't take it too light, these things I said. Final judgment over all, like a full-fledged king. Some are sentenced to death, others never to sing. I'm chilling for the moment. Yes, my friend, in a minute I'll be making 6 G's times 10. This might put you in a state of shock. It's not how much you make, it's how good you rock. Just to let you know who DJ's greater, Molly Wack Buffett, Commonaut Cut Creator.
What's good? It's your man MC Shan, and you tuned into the G-Lew Show, Flashback Fridays. Y'all already know what it is. One time for your mind, two times for your soul.
Hey, hold up, man. Hold up. Give me some music. Hey, man, it's the world-famous G-Lew Show, Flashback Fridays. And like I told you, we got a special guest, a legend, straight out of Queens Bridge. The Bridge, the world-famous legendary MC Shan, ladies and gentlemen, on the G-Lew Show.
Y'all must got me on caller ID. What's happening, G-Lew? What's happening?
Hey, man, what's up, love one? How you doing tonight, Shan?
I'm chilling. When we start this, right, can I just open up the show right by trying to, you know, just clear something up?
Okay. Go ahead, sir.
All right. So there's a little one-minute clip that makes things sound kind of bad when I say, oh, the Shantae movie was all fake or whatever. It ain't all. It's like the part I'm talking about is motherfucking Chris being a fucking gangster. That's some fake shit. And motherfucking, okay. Nah, he was a motherfucking, huh?
You mean KRS-One?
No, not that, the nigga in the movie.
Okay,
you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
I don't want niggas to think I'm dogging my sister, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
You know, the part about him being a gangster nigga, that wasn't, you know what I'm saying? He was a cool-ass nigga. He had respect, but blah. And the part of motherfucking, you know, us letting him, that nigga, he was a down-low beater. And I could be mad because, yo, she would have knew that if she'd have told us what was going on with that, he'd have got beat up. So that's the end of that story. So when I say, motherfucking, yeah, that shit was fake, just that part of it right there. Niggas, that, and see,
okay.
Y'all got me tonight drunk like I'm always drinking my Moscatos. But motherfuckers like to ask me open-ended questions and shit. You know what I'm saying? And don't specify
right.
What the fuck you mean. So I had to specify that shit before it get out of hand real quick. And thank you for letting me do that, G-Lew. Now, let's get to what we doing.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Let's do it. First and foremost, man, you know, you gave them some background. They know who you are. But just for everybody listening, man, just give a formal introduction. You know, because I can do it, but only you can, you know, do it and give the full gist of who you are, man, and what you represent. You know what I mean? And the struggle you come from and, you know, just the monumental mark you left on hip hop.
Look, I come from the same struggle everybody else come from. You know what I'm saying? I'm just somebody that lived my dreams and tried to fulfill my dreams. My name is MC Shan. I come from Queensbridge. I've done things that you can also do. I'm no greater than you. You know what I'm saying? I haven't achieved anything that you can't achieve in your life is all I'm saying. So reach for your goals, because I reach for mine, because I'm from the bridge, the bridge.
That's right. That's right. Hey, take us back a bit, Shan, if you would, man. Just you mentioned Queensbridge. You know, so many people hear about Queensbridge. You know, the legends that come from there, you know, starting with you, Marley Marl. But take us back to Queensbridge, man. Tell us about Queensbridge and what's special about that project, you know, housing project, being one of the largest, if not the largest in the world. Take us back to Queensbridge a bit and tell us how it all started, man.
But, see, like I keep saying, Queensbridge is no different than anybody else's hood. It was just the opportunities that were given to us, being that Marley was from there and the radio was controlled by Mr. Magic as far as hip-hop was concerned back then. And me being one of those forefront artists that was in the game and being one of those that was first on the radio type of thing, you know what I'm saying? And having things played that I made in the afternoon. If I made it in the afternoon, it was on the radio that night. And Nas and them seeing this, but I just was a regular person. I used to hang out on the block and do everything that everybody else did. And everybody in Queensbridge would tell you that, you know what I'm saying? It was just regular old Shan. And if I made an influence on them, then so be it. But that wasn't my intention. I was just having fun being a kid. I was 19, 20 years old, you know what I'm saying?
Right. Right. Also, Shan, tell us about the strong connection you mentioned, how you would make a song and it would be on the radio that night because you had the connection with Mr. Magic, legendary Mr. Magic, rest in peace, one who started off, you know, I'm sure, hip-hop radio in New York. But tell us about the connection with Mr. Magic that,
Queensbridge had. Marley Marl, he was Mr. Magic's DJ, Marley Marl with the mixing gloves. All right?
Yes, sir.
So now, I was Marley's MC. I used to go up to Mr. Magic's radio show and answer the phones. You know, when they say, oh, 107.5, you know, or HBI, I would go up there and answer the phones because I had to make my way. You know how you got to make your bones?
Right.
So making your bones in the juice crew, meaning that you had to go get the coffee, you had to answer the hotline. So that's what it was, you know what I'm saying? And it was different because if I made a song in the afternoon, it would be on the radio that night because we wasn't on an FCC regulated station. Well, it was FCC regulated where you just couldn't curse and all that, but you wasn't mandated to play what the PDs told you to play, the same as your radio show is now.
Right, right.
You don't have to listen to anyone. You can play whatever you want to play and talk to who you want to talk to.
Right, right, right. Also, the Juice Crew, tell us about the origins of that. Because, you know, when people hear the Juice Crew, they think of the MCs and you and, you know, Craig G and, you know, everybody in the Juice Crew. But, you know, it started before that since we mentioned Mr. Magic. Can you tell us about the origins of the Juice Crew?
Well, the origins of the Juice Crew started well before us. It started with Sal and Disco Fever in the Bronx and Melly Mel and all them cats and Fearless Four and them cats up there. They were the first fraction of the Juice Crew. Mr. Magic was a person in that conglomerate that could break away and make his own clan. So we, the Juice Crew that people know, actually is a subsidiary that Magic broke off and made his own. So Super Rock and Mr. Magic took and made the Juice Crew that y'all know, Shantae, Shan, Craig G, Master Ace, and he developed that because he had the power to just say, I'm going to make my own. Because who's going to tell him anything? He was the man on the radio. He made hip-hop what it is today, even though people don't know that. He was the only one playing hip-hop on the radio back in the days. Like, I let my tape pop, my tape rock till my tape pop. Mr. Magic, Marley Marl, Biggie Smalls even mentioned him. So, you know, that got to let some of these young cats know that Mr. Magic was an influential part of what we're doing nowadays.
Right, right, right. Right. I also heard that Mr. Magic, shout out to Mr. Magic, rest in peace again, but I heard he wasn't like, I don't know the words to say, I don't want to be disrespectful, but I heard he would let a person know how he felt, you know what I mean? If your record
he was
back,
he wouldn't play
like, a lot of people didn't
you.
Like him, didn't know
look,
how to approach him. Go ahead.
This was my partner in crime. He didn't give two forks.
Right.
About shit. You know what I'm saying? And would tell
right.
you right quick, yo, I'm super rocking Mr. Magic.
Mm.
Alright, and if you decide you wanted to put hands on him because nobody was around with him, he'll be like, yo, my girl hit harder than you. which will piss you off even more. Because now you
right.
swung on this nigga thinking, you know, yeah, I'm going to play Mr. Magic. And he'd look at you talking about, yo, my girl hit harder.
Wow.
Yeah, it was just that dude, yo.
Yeah.
It was that
yeah.
dude.
Rest in peace to Mr. Magic. Hey,
and
also,
it wasn't a thing. It wasn't a
ahead,
thing of people didn't like him. He was one of those that, yo, everybody got the same ego as Magic now. So what everybody's saying, oh, they didn't like him. Everybody's got egos now, you know what I'm saying? There's a lot of people out here that got egos that were just like Mr. Magic to say what they got to say. You don't like them because of their ego, you know what I'm saying? But he was like the first asshole ever.
Right, right, right.
And hey, I can say that because that's my man. That's my fucking
right.
partner, yo. He showed me how to be an asshole, so fuck it.
Rest in peace, Mr. Magic. Hey, Shan, you mentioned when mentioning the origins of the Juice Crew, the original members, you mentioned the homie Sal from the Disco Fever, and a lot of people may not know. Speaking on Sal, that was the guy in Crush Groove movie, correct?
Yes, it was.
Yes, yeah. Shout out to Sal. That's some history right there. There was a lot of people in that movie, even though it was changed
Listen,
or whatever
Sal
for the movie.
Sal keeps a lot of artists
history.
Working right now. Although
okay.
he might be a part of hip-hop history, Sal
mm-hmm.
keeps a lot of the old-school artists doing shows and working in these casinos because he's got, you know, connections with casinos and whatnot. So you'll be working in some of these big casinos, and I'm like, I did a couple of casinos, and I'm like, what they know about MC Shan in the casino? Who cares,
right.
Sal? Here's your check. This is
right.
what we
wow.
doing tonight. You know what I mean?
Right, right. Also, we mentioned Crush Groove, right? I wanted to ask you this offline, but let me ask you this. The connection, you know, being at Queens is a big borough, you know, but Queensbridge is definitely, like I said, has its place in hip-hop. But mentioning Crush Groove, you know, we had the early MCs, you know, a lot of MCs from Hollis, Queens, Run DMC being a few, one of the biggest. Was there ever any connection with Hollis and Queensbridge? We never seen any of those collaborations, really, at least not back in the day.
No. I mean, they had their thing. I mean, come on. Before me, every rapper yelled and was raw. I showed rappers
right.
how to be smooth. I was like the forefather of the Kings and Rakims, where you come
right.
in with your own smooth style. LL, you remember how he used to rhyme back in the days? Run. Everybody used to mail. Everybody used to, you know, yell to get their point across till I came across with all of his beats and my rhymes attached. Formed a new creation called the Molly Scratch, you know? And from there,
right.
the whole game changed because I didn't have, my voice was authentic. It was different. My voice was just, you know, just being me.
Right.
When I'm talking nowadays, walking through the stores or whatever, people will look at me, you know, so, yo, ain't you blah, blah, blah? I knew it from your voice because, you know, I didn't rhyme like, yah, 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 yah. I changed the whole game. And anybody that could dispute that, go ahead. I want to see you dispute it.
Right, right, right. Right. Yeah, I just wanted to ask that question because I never, about Hollis and Queensbridge, you know, we never really. No one ever made that connection back in the day, you know.
We ain't make that connection. Queensbridge was our own island, our own little six blocks of terror. We didn't bother with nobody else. We did our own thing. Whatever y'all doing over there, that's what y'all doing. End of story.
Right. Okay, okay, okay. There it is, there it is. Shan, I wanted to ask you this. We brought up, you know, the Juice Crew, and we brought up Roxanne Shanté. I did not know this. You know, I learned this recently, but Roxanne was actually the first to have a record out and doing some shit before you did, and then you came along. Can you speak on the origins of Roxanne and the impact she had and how you, came in after her and the connection you all had early on?
And see, this is why I'm glad you bring that up, because that's why I had to clear that up in the beginning.
Right.
Because Shanté is the reason that all of us Juice Crew members exist, period, point blank. She took me on tour while she was the hottest thing on the planet.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So that launched my career and whatnot. And so it really, I know how she probably looking at it. She knows she ain't going to say what he going to say. And she ain't going to be offended by what I said. But I had to clear it up because some people's minds are not, you know, they just look clickbait. They ain't understanding that that's a 1 minute clip, and they took the best part that they can get people to click on. And if you want to ask me, like I said, the fakest part of that shit wasn't about how her story. That's how it happened. Everything happened except for that nigga wasn't no gangster like that, and he was doing whatever. But if it wasn't for her, Kane or none of us would be having our slot at all. You know what I'm saying? She opened up the doors for everybody. She took me on tour. I took Biz, and then Biz got put with her. And then Biz bringing Kane and Swan, and Ace came along. Craig G, he just came along with the package because he was Queensbridge, you know what I'm saying? Him and Tragedy. Only thing, Tragedy, he had a little bit of misfortune at his younger age and whatnot, but he still was part of what we was doing in Queensbridge.
Right. And where did Master
came out of here? I don't.
Where did Master Ace? I just right quick. Where did Master Ace come in at? And was he from Queensbridge?
Master Ace. How Master Ace came in? It was like y'all see that Marley Marl In Control album cover, right?
Right.
Marley always had a trick. He'd say, "Yo, let's go make a tape," but the next thing you know, that tape become a record. And you get pennies on the dollar for that. I'm like, yeah, I'm used to that trick, so I'm not going. So the day they went and made Symphony, I said, I'm going home. Y'all go ahead and do that. And instead of me being on the song, Master Ace was on the song.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Master Ace probably would have still been on the song, regardless to the fact everybody would have just had shorter bars or whatever. But he had to earn his way onto that song because he was rhyming with Craig G. He was rhyming with Big Daddy Kane, and he was rhyming with Kool G Rap. You understand? And here he is, Master Ace. He's just, yo, who is this nigga? You know what I'm saying? So he had to hold his own in order to become who the hell he is and have his own status in the Juice Crew. So it's not like it was given to him. Or just because I wasn't there and that he automatic. Nah, he had to hold his own. He was getting on, like I said, he was getting on the record with Craig G, Master Ace, and was like the new guy. Big Daddy Kane is on this joint. And Kool G Rap, are you kidding? Didn't you not hear the competition that was on that fucking song? Excuse me for saying that. Did you not hear it?
Yes.
You don't want to hear how ill everybody, they was just turned up. Everybody was turned up on the symphony. You know what I'm saying? That's how it is when you get ill MCs in one room on one song.
Right. So and Master Ace, did he come from Brooklyn? Where was he from? Was he from Brooklyn? He wasn't from Queensbridge. Yeah.
No, he wasn't from Queensbridge. He was from Brooklyn. Okay. Tyrone knew his mother.
Okay.
And he was in college at the time when Ace got introduced to us, you know. But still, he had to hook up, but he still had to hold his own in the structure of the Juice Crew and how the Juice Crew worked.
Right. And how did you feel about that? Because I jumped off. I want to get back to Roxanne. But how did you feel about that song when you didn't want to be a part of it and the shit blew up later?
What's that?
Did you feel after the song when
no,
it came out. We,
I still, okay, cool. No, I didn't, because I still get asked about it. See, you asked me about the song. See?
Okay. I just brought it up.
But see, you ask anybody, look, ask anybody else how they, wait a minute, ask everybody else how they feel. If they feel the same way I felt back then, but I knew better. How much you making off that supersonic, super historic song? How much money you getting off that? Oh, you can't pay your rent this month? Oh, okay, I thought so. So you go ahead and ask them how they feel about that song. Don't ask me. I already knew the question or the answer to the question that you were going to ask.
All righty then. All righty. That's enough of that. Let's
keep
get back to
1,000.
That's right. That's right. We respect that, Shan. You always though speak. You know, you've never been one to bite your tongue, so I don't expect you to do it now, homie. You know what I mean? So respect. Going back though to the Shantae thing, like you said, much respect to Shantae. She's the reason everybody pretty much got put on when she blew up and took everybody with her. But after you get on with Shantae, what was the first song that you released and you know, before you blew up and everything like that, when you caught some buzz and
my first record was Molly Scratch.
Yeah, okay. There we go.
That was my first record, and that was the one that I say, if I made it in the afternoon, it was going to be on the radio that night.
Right.
And I still remember the night that Molly played that on the radio like it was yesterday.
Okay, so
the bridge comes out.
Go ahead.
No, but see, you got to understand that the bridge was a cassette in Queensbridge for 2 years before the world ever heard it. So that was a cassette that Queensbridge knew about 2 years before anybody ever heard that on the radio, or we decided to ever make it a record. We just thought that, yo, ain't nobody going to like that song. It's only about Queensbridge. So we didn't try and push it as a record. So we just had it as a tape in Queensbridge for 2 years until he just said, fuck it, and played it on the radio. And it took off from there.
Okay, so fast forward, when the bridge comes out, takes off on the radio, blows up, I'm sure around New York first, and then it just blows up everywhere. What's going
on
now?
Chris talking about Queensbridge. Hip-hop didn't start in Queensbridge, and I never said it started in Queensbridge. I said, let me tell you a little story about where they come from. Oh, Molly said that.
Right.
Fast forwarding.
Right.
And
but
the reason why
that,
I never came back with why I never came back with a response to whatever song came after the first one is because Molly didn't want to do another song. He figured it was going to make them famous. But me as an MC, and back in them days, you didn't have computers like everybody got computers now, and you could make your own song. You had to go with what the producer did. So Molly didn't want to make another song about them. Not that he was scared of them. He didn't think, you know, but he like, I don't want to make them famous. And I'm looking at him like, yo, what are you talking about? They getting famous off that last shit they made. So that's why I never made another song about that, because my producer said no. And back in them days, not everybody knew what they were doing in the studio.
Right. So later after this comes, but even before the South Bronx song, the bridge song had a lot of success. You know, now I'm sure you're going on tour and all of this. You know, before the KRS thing comes. But then the KRS thing comes, you know, you go through that stage and all of that. Then what happens, you know, after that? You know, you didn't respond. You kept it moving. What happens after that? Because now the Juice Crew is no longer about MC Shan. You got Kane, everybody else coming along. And what's going on at this time?
Just new members of the Juice Crew is coming in, and you had to go through the ranks. See, I get a lot of flack for calling Big Daddy Kane a new nigga. But that's just right. How the Juice Crew worked. You like I said, ask any of them. When you was new in the Juice Crew, when we got to the airport, you had to get the bags from the fucking carousel. All right? That's how it worked. You know what I'm saying? All of that crap that had to be done, you got to go get the Crate of Records or whatever. You got to be responsible for this. You're the new nigga. We get off the plane and we just get in the car like nothing ever happened. But you got to handle all that. It was initiations. You know what I'm saying? There was always a low man on the totem pole, and I always tell Kane this. I say, it's not my fault that you didn't use your superiority when Ace and all whoever came after you, you know what I'm saying, and call them the new nigga. It ain't my fault. We just got different personalities, you know what I'm saying? But it ain't. It wasn't nothing, because a lot of people be saying, yo, you call Kane a new nigga, you was a hater. No, it wasn't nothing about hate. You know what I'm saying? It was just, that's just how the Juice Crew ran.
Right.
I had more stripes than everybody else. So what the hell?
Right. Shout out to Big Daddy Kane.
When Magic say, yo, get that. When Magic say, go get him off of stage, Magic is the 5-star general. So, yo, me not being a foot soldier, I got to go on stage and tell this little private, yo, you got to get off the stage. You understand? Because there was a chain of command, and that's just how it was. You know? All in fun, all in family, and this is what we was building, this conglomerate. If you couldn't take it, you couldn't be down. That's the end of that.
Right. And now, like I said, moving forward, though, what's going on with Shan? Do we with the next stage of Shan's career with the Juice Crew?
I was defending hip hop at a point. When I put out Play It Again, Shan, if anybody knows about the years that it was and what kind of flack from record companies, from magazines, from everything, saying that hip hop is not an art form, it's not gonna last, it's not musically entertaining. What I did with Play It Again, Shan, was, all right, instead of me sampling, I like this bass line like that. And I put it together and I made it musical. You know what I'm saying? I took Cab Calloway, It Don't Mean a Thing, and put some rhymes to it. I did house music. I did all kind of things just to say to all of these people who are saying rap is not artistic, I'm giving them the finger with that MC Shan, Play It Again, Shan. Put on a tux, all of that. You know what I'm saying? This is right. Music. We can do it over music. But I'm going to take that bullet because I know what was going on in hip-hop about that time when they're saying this. I know what the magazines were saying. I know when they were saying that hip-hop ain't gonna last past this amount of years. And hip-hop is still here. But y'all wasn't there to understand and witness this. So you wouldn't understand where I came from making an album like that. I'm here. I am on a major label. And part of the fact that they kind of convinced me to do some popular music in kind of a way, because, yo, they'll try and mold you and shape you in this business. But I still was trying to defend my art form, period. Y'all go ahead and mold and shape me. Go ahead and get Carol Davis on the record. I don't know who Carol Davis is. That's the Caucasian lady and Don't Mean a Thing. I don't know her, but they think that's a great idea if you get Carol Davis. Yeah, I don't even know who she is. I'm from the project. What y'all talking about? Whatever. You know what I'm saying?
Right. And you know, respectfully so, man. That was a classic that you put out, you know. But again, you know, we're moving forward with hip hop. You know, you're coming into a stage of late '80s. Hip hop is changing. We had a lot of different players come and go. You know, even Kane did his thing heavy, you know, but we're coming to a different age. Hip hop is changing. What's going on with Shan at this point? How do you feel about hip hop when it took a shift?
How I feel about hip hop, I was on some fuck hip hop, and I'm going to say it that way straight out. For the simple fact is the record company is putting wedges and all kind of in between the artists. At one point, Warner Brothers dropped me because I wasn't one of them artists that's going to conform. You know what I'm saying? Oh, Shan needs to act this kind of way when he's out in public and blah, blah, blah. Oh, shut the fuck up. I'm getting high. I'm smoking my weed public, whatever. Y'all shut up. I wasn't fit for their mold. You see what I'm saying? Kane was more fit for their mold. Biz was, they didn't get high. They didn't smoke weed. They didn't get drunk. They didn't care. You know, I was that one. I didn't fit their mold. So it was
right.
Fuck hip hop. They didn't want to drop me. I went and found a Canadian Irishman and made the record Informer. And so
right.
By the time I made Informer, made me more money than I ever made in hip hop. I've been living off of Informer up until this day. And now here we are on this day. Daddy Yankee just took that same Informer that I made back in 92 and he made it again. It's called Con Karma, but it's the same melody as mine. You know the publishing where it goes.
Right.
And it's 1 billion hits in 4 or 5 months on YouTube. Number one in so many countries, I can't even count it. And this is here in 2019. So I'm just sitting back looking at life regurgitate itself. Because this
right.
is such a big hit. If any of y'all want to go check, go look at Con Karma by Daddy Yankee. Go look at it. Go see how many. And it's got Katy Perry on the remix. Come on now. It's on
right,
pop
right.
radio. It's on Spanish radio. I was just down in Florida. Every time you turn on the station, you hear, bah. You know what I'm saying? I get writers. I get publishers. Come on. My paperwork was on point. Not in my rap career, but as I stepped away from rap career and I did other things, it paid off for me. Last
right.
week, I went and bought a boat. And guess why? Because Con Karma is so hot. Not that I was broke or nothing, but I can't calm myself so hard. I just, I don't want to buy a boat.
I went and bought a boat. Hey, check this out. Take us back a little bit because you mentioned the Yankee new song, but we mentioned Informer. Like I said, once hip hop changed, you step back and all that. How did that come about? How did that hookup come about with you and the rapper Snow where Informer was made? And what was your input on that record for the people who
all
may
right,
not know?
So here's how it goes. I produced a whole 12 inches of Snow from song one to song N, except for one, Runway. And that was produced by DJ Prince. And DJ Prince is the one that introduced me to Snow. I met him, and like I said, the best thing that weed ever did for me was I was going to the weed spot when I met Snow's DJ. And he told me, he said, yo, I got a white boy to do reggae. I said, sure, you right. Shut up. You know what I'm saying? He said, all right. So 2 weeks later, he brings Snow to America. And when he bring him there that night, I met Snow. We went to my studio. We went in there and recorded Informer, and the rest is history. That's all I can say.
Mm. Mm. That part right there. And hold on, Shan.
Look,
since you
that
said
song
that,
is in the Guinness Book of World Records twice.
Hold on.
Exactly. I got a lot of accolades that I don't even speak on. You know, people always trying to play me, and I say that book, that song is in, and it outsold Bob Marley. You know what I'm saying? It's in the Guinness Book of World Records twice, and that's something I don't really say to people. You know, I got a lot of accolades under my belt that I don't speak about because I don't have to.
You don't have to. The numbers don't lie, man. The numbers don't lie. MC Shan, hold on. He mentioned this record. Let me go to this right quick to get people abreast of what Shan did and how he still gets paid to this day.
Oh, they came around looking for you the other day.
Word,
bust it.
I'm a stormy, I go glam. I like you, boom, boom, bam. Take them on the stage, they don't miss me, stand somewhere down the lane. I like you, boom, boom, bam. Informer, you know, say that I'm a stormy, I go glam. I like you, boom, boom, bam. Take them on the stage, they don't miss me, stand somewhere down the lane. I like you, boom, bam. These are the men who come in, they blow down my doors.
When he come out through my window, so they put me in the back of the car at the station. From that point on, I reach my destination. Where the destination region at the east extension. Where them look down my pants, look up my bottom. So informers, you know, say that I'm a snowman, I go glam. I lick it boom boom down. Take them on the city, then I'm a snowman, stop somewhere down the lane. I lick it boom boom down. Informer, you know, say that I'm a snowman, I go glam. I lick it boom boom down. Take them on the city, then I'm a snowman, stop somewhere down the lane. I lick it boom boom down. So big on them, they think they have more power. They on the phone, me say they want a one. If it was a user, what's the name? Call me lover. Love who be calling on the one, tell me. I'm in love with my heart down to my belly. Yes, and I'm a summer, I'll be cool and deadly. It's the one MC Shan and the one that is true. Together we all have them, it's a tornado. Informer, you know, say that I'm a summer, I'll go glam. I lick you boom boom down. Take them on the city, then I'm a summer, start somewhere down the lane. I lick you boom boom down. Informer, you know, say that I'm a summer, I'll go glam. I lick you boom boom down. Take them on the city, then I'm a summer, start somewhere down the lane. I lick you boom boom down. So listen for me, you better listen for me now. Listen for me, you better listen for me now. Bring me the rubber, the microphone, but the rock on stage. You see that I'm a summer, you're the article done. But I'm not in and I'm the dance. I mean, say where you come from. People them say you come from Jamaica, but me born and raised in Connecticut. Don't know what you know. Few brown people, man, is all I'm on. No, yeah, my shoes are empty, rapping on me toes, it's a show. With me, you're ballin' on the one Toronto. So informer, you know, say that I'm a summer, you're the glam. I lick you boom boom down. Take them on the stage, say that I'm a summer, start somewhere down the lane. I lick you boom boom down. Informer, you know, say that I'm a summer, you're the glam. I lick you boom boom down. Take them on the stage, say that I'm a summer, start somewhere down the lane. I lick you boom boom down. Come with a nice young lady, intelligent, yes, she juggling Ari.
Okay, that's enough. I just wanted to give him a taste of it, Shan, because that's, like you said, in the Guinness Book of World Records, twice, you know, MC Shan did that.
Two times. It's going to be three times now because it's going to be like the one-hit wonder that was two times a hit wonder.
Right. Hey, whatever happened to Snow?
Nothing. He's
living good
in Canada doing his thing.
Right, doing his thing.
You want to talk about people that are just, you know, he can't come to the States. I can't go to Canada, so we just separated by border.
Right. Okay.
Sometimes things happen in your life where you just got to be bound to your state and your country.
Right. It's all good. We got the legendary MC Shan, man. Queensbridge royalty on the G-Lew Show Flashback Fridays. Hey, Shan, let me go to the phone line. Somebody wants to check in with us, maybe ask you a question or so. Let me go to the phone line real quick. Caller, hello. You're live with MC Shan.
Man, MC Shan, the legend.
This is Rev Ali
from Los Angeles, California. Man, I just want to tell you, man, you a legend down here on my block where I grew up over here on the west side of Los Angeles, man. We love you, man. Whatever you do, whatever you did, man, we just happy you around and you helped kick the door in for rap music and music, period, really. Because once you in music, man, it don't really matter what genre, man, because when you kick the door in, you got sounds and beats and songs that's, you know, legendary. You know, that's music to me. It ain't really rap, rock, pop or whatever they want to call it, you know what I'm saying? So I appreciate you, man, for doing whatever you did to still be here today. God bless you, my brother. I love you, man.
Check this out. I got to appreciate y'all from the west side because remember, back in the days, I used to wear one red shoe and one blue shoe. Do y'all know how many passes they gave me in Los Angeles?
I can imagine how many passes.
Yo, I walked up in Nickerson Gardens like that. I'm telling you. I walked up in Nickerson Gardens with one red shoe and one blue shoe. One man, I was at one donut shop, right? And the man's son tried to talk to me. Yo, he snatched his son's arm so quick and walked away from me so fast like I was fucking nuts. But
well,
L.A.,
you know, like,
anytime I went to L.A., they didn't look at me as if I was representing this or representing that. They looked at me as MC Shan, the artist. They respected me for what I was. I respected what they did. You know what I'm saying? I never claimed any set trip or none of that. You know, what I was doing was being an ignorant person from New York, not knowing that this red and blue was so serious in Los Angeles. But I got to give respect to all my folks on that side of the world that gave me that pass. You understand?
Amen, man. Amen. You know, my dad, he was born in New York. So when, you know, when folks be talking about, you know, New York and East Coast, West Coast, I said, man, let me tell you something, man. I said, most folks that's from out here that's in the West Coast ain't even from the West Coast. So y'all need to check yourself when you run that game like that. You know what I'm saying? Because we all one, man. They don't know where your mama and daddy came from. They have no clue, and they out here acting a damn fool. So I appreciate
right,
you, man,
but
like
if
I
they
said.
They studied the real history of that West Coast. They would know that a lot of black folks migrated to that because they were promised jobs and housing that was different than what they were
right.
used to.
Exactly. You there you know? Go. So you just enlightened me and reminded me to see that. There you go. See, that's what I'm saying. Real history, real knowledge, man, and real wisdom, brother. We love you, man. I hope you make some more hit records. You know, I'll go buy it and support it, you know, for you, man. I love you, man. Thanks, G. Lou, for keeping, you know,
what
this channel open
for
folks to do it.
Understand nowadays, my brother, that all of that buying records thing is a thing of the past. You get paid the same for streams. So if any of y'all out there support any of these old school artists, go stream their stuff. You don't have to buy it. If you love it and, you know, you still into it, because they're going to still do music if you listen to it. If you show them that you just as much want to listen to it as much as they want to make it, there's no buying it nowadays. How do you think these little young cats, they ain't buying it. When the last time you seen a CD? Oh, silence, crickets, what happened? Ain't nobody seen a CD in how long?
Yeah, it's been a minute,
you know what I'm
man.
Saying?
It's been a minute. It's been a minute,
right.
But you know,
so
they bringing it back a little bit, though, man, a little bit.
Huh?
They bringing it back a little bit with the CDs, you know, because especially out here on the West Coast, man, folks is going back to that old Eazy-E way, man, coming out the trunk. You know, they want to, you know, give a person something real, you know, because that digital form and that online media stuff really ain't no communication with folks. So folks starting to wake up a little bit and get back to that. But I understand exactly what you're saying, because you're an OG, like you were saying, you know, you're getting, you know, residuals from, you know, the guy put your song out and use some of your music. So, you know, you got checks coming, and we need to do is know that, let you know that we are here still
but
checking.
But now, look, see, we got to understand the little man that can't afford to go burn all them CDs. He got to make his way on the internet like everybody else and build up his format. You know what I'm saying? To make the same amount of money that them same cats that could afford them CDs and selling them out their trunk. We got to remember economics to us. Now, if you got a young black man that can't afford to do this, what you think he going to do to get the money? You know what I'm saying? What you think
right.
he's going to do? He's not going to go get a job. He's going to do something negative that's going to either land him in jail or do something that's going to further take our hoods or our neighborhoods into a decline. So, you know what I'm saying? Not everybody has the means to make the CD, so we got to support that too. We got to get on the internet and say, well, you know what I'm saying? If
yeah,
we can afford to buy the CD, and we got to support no matter how it got to be.
That's right, man. You said
and
that. Dream. I couldn't have said it no better. I couldn't
nice
said it no better.
Say, it's nice to say, yes, I sold this amount of CDs and things like that, but that's not the way of the world anymore. They're trying to bring that back so they can actually account for some money and charge these artists. Because you got to figure this. If you make one MP3, there's no physical hard copy. You sell one MP3 to 500 million people. There's no overhead. There's no residual recourse for burning the CDs, the jackets, the covers, how many plastics, the promotion, the this, the that. There's no residual for it. So, of course, they want to bring the CD back because they're not being able to rob you for the money that they robbed me for.
Right, right.
Come on, dude. Are we not hearing what I say? You sell people, you can sell 500 million people the same one MP3 or WAVE. You, once you put it up on that digital form, it's on every digital outlet that there is. And you're selling that one MP3, and it costs you nothing to put it there, except for the few dollars that you had to register with your provider. You know what I'm saying? So yes, which way would you rather go? Would you rather go with the CDs and get charged for all of this packaging and all of this, or just continue to do it the internet way that they introduced us to? Because the other way, it was jerking us all the way around. This way, we can all get our money on our own because they can't do nothing without us.
Amen. Amen. You're right about that, man. You know, I just gonna look over. I'm gonna do both sides. I'm gonna do the digital. But you're right. I'll start the digital, and then once I gain a little money, then I'll go and satisfy some of them people that like them real hard copies too. You know. So you're right, man.
Yes, sir. Hey, Ali.
It's not dumb to not do it both ways, but see, when it's feasible, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
if
yeah,
you find
yeah.
you got your audience that's gonna buy that, then that makes more sense to do that. But some of these cats ain't got the same clientele that you have. So we got to support
Or what it is, I noticed this too. When I put out music, you have people, like you said, it's definitely easier to do the digital, like you said, less overhead, and you can reach more people. But then you're going to have your certain fans that may be overseas, Japan or whatnot, that want a physical copy. So it's good to have both on hand, you know what I mean? But the digital world is definitely where it's at, like Shan said, you know, just to reach
okay.
more people.
Now,
and
another one where I'm going to say this, right? Oh, you want to put your hands on a CD? What happened? You ain't got a CD burner in your computer? You want a physical CD? Burn it, your goddamn self.
Exactly.
On,
yeah, exactly.
That, yo?
But you, what I was only saying, Shan, was you have some people like that may be in a different country who aren't over here with us, and they still respect the art form, and they respect the artist where they want a hard copy or maybe autograph that they can have for their collection. You know what I mean? And they
look,
may be willing to pay extra as
did
well.
Did you not know? Let me let you in on something. Did you not know that Amazon will burn them a CD? You design your copy or you design your jacket or whatever, and Amazon will burn them a CD if they want. They'll sell them a digital copy if they want digital.
That's right. You said
I didn't know
they'll
that,
sell
man.
Them a
digital. Yep.
But Amazon
game.
Will sell you a hard copy if you want a hard copy of that same digital stuff.
I didn't know that.
That's
man.
Right. I just did that, G-Lew.
How do you go about that? I want to do
but
that.
But when you go on Amazon, you can ask for a hard copy, and they'll go ahead and print one out and with the picture and everything, just like Shan just told you.
Okay. Wow.
Not costing
okay,
you
gave
any
me some game.
At all.
You gave me some game, Shan and Ali. I did not know that. You gave me some game.
All
thank
right,
you.
But look, that didn't cost you no overhead at all. All you got to do is take and make the picture within the realm or the specs that they wanted in. They want it by 1,200 by 1,200 or 1,600 right. by whatever. You send them the JPEG.
And
it
really,
they
Shan,
print
Shan,
it out
listen.
For you.
And really, you already have that because, like I said, I put out music in the same way. You're not putting out a digital CD, but when you put it out digitally, you still need all those things for your cover and all of that. So it's really already there. You know what I mean? When you submit your music to your distributor digitally, you still have to have a cover, art form, and all that, which they you needed and
credit,
like you said,
everything.
Exactly. So it's already there, really. So like you said, if you go to Amazon, they can pretty much produce it from that because you already have those layers, the JPEG, the 14
by 12. That's the way it came to them.
Yeah, okay.
There you go. That's the way it came
yeah.
to them.
Okay.
So they're going to say, yo, either you want this kind or you want this kind, and they're going to give it to you.
Right. Yeah.
That's
hey,
gangster.
G-Lew, I got to take care of these dogs, cats, and rabbits, man. But listen, I'm gonna send you a picture of one of the CDs that Amazon sent me so you can see. You'd be like, man, that looks like they got it out of – you know, back in the days at Big Ben's or something, the warehouse.
Okay.
I'm glad I could be of some service.
Thank
oh,
you.
Oh, yes,
man.
Sir.
Thank you, Ali.
He's real. See, Shan always been real. So we love you from the day you started until now. You're still dropping jewels, man. Love you, man.
Yes, sir.
Appreciate
you. Thank you, Ali.
Let me speak some.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Ali, man. Again, man. How do your business, man? Much love, bro.
He sound like my house. We got lizards, dogs, ducks. and those that follow my Instagram at MCShan1. Yeah. MCShan1 is my Instagram. Y'all will see me on a regular basis.
Hey, it's a live reality show. Hey, it's a live reality show with MC Shan on Instagram. Please go follow him now. MC Shan1 on Instagram, man. You will get some entertainment, man. Most definitely. definitely, man. I love it, Shan. I love it. I was following you way before we set this up, so it's all good, man. But Shan, we mentioned one more thing about hip hop. We mentioned like the homie Ali just spoke about. You gave props to what's going on now with the digital age and how people get their money, because it's definitely a lot of more money generating through these artists now. But how do you feel about hip hop overall right now at the state we're in?
Besides the
financial. Yeah, I understand
hip-hop.
That. But you come from hip hop, so I'm sure you're still, you know, you got to still see what's going
I'd
on.
I'd love to, but here's why. Because the business of hip hop is so screwed up to artists. And screwed up to us, that is either you're going to take a stand or you're just going to fall for anything. You don't find Barbara Streisand and them starving for nothing. They feeding their horses when we barely feeding our kids. How come our artists are going out and doing stupid tours at 60 years old and they still got to do it just to put food on the table? They can't decide to say, well, I don't want to do that tour. They have to do that tour. I don't want to be that artist. I want to change. So it's like I'm not going to contribute to that. Y'all want to keep paying me crap. You don't want to pay me what I'm worth for doing this. You want to give these new mumble rappers $300,000 to do some bull crap that nobody don't even know the words to. I'm not doing y'all shows. Y'all can keep the crumbs and spread those crumbs amongst those who want them. It's just right. that I've been fortunate enough that something that I did 27 years ago has resurfaced and took off the same way that it took off the first time. But only this time, it's digital. So it's way bigger than what it did. And I know what Informer did. And I know what those physical copies did and blah, 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 blah. So I know what type of bread I'm getting ready to see.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to die living okay. So I'm saying to the hip-hop game, I've never made money off of hip-hop like this. Everybody in hip-hop, black people, they trying to jerk you. Nobody's trying to give you a helping hand. Anytime I made money, I made it with an Irishman, and I'm making it with a Puerto Rican now. Okay?
Right.
I don't want to deal with hip-hop with people that's going to sell out arenas and give us $2,000, $3,000, $4,000 as old school artists. When you know what I'm saying? That's the first five rows of seats that you're selling out, and you're paying every artist on the show. I'm not with that anymore. So I quit. No more G School shows. No more none of that shit. I ain't with it. Fuck it. Unless y'all niggas gonna pay me what the fuck is worth. Excuse me for saying that again. Y'all already know
right.
if you follow my Instagram, there's a whole bunch of those F words flying.
right. Hey,
So that's what it is.
Right. And we know you quit hip hop, you know,
let me set this right?
Okay.
I would do free shows for the fans.
Mm-hmm.
If the fans say, yo, Shan, show up right here, we all gonna show up. We're gonna make sure the DJ got you on the motherfucking microphone. I would show up there before I would show up to somebody trying to belittle my work. I would come do it for y'all for free every single time with no hesitation. But for them dudes, nope. For their personal monetary gain, can't get me to do it. Sorry.
Hey, Shan, let me ask you this. You just answered the question, but let me ask you this. Why wasn't there, I mean, even years back, wasn't there ever like a reunion Juice Crew tour or collaboration or anything, you know, because we've seen over the years a lot of the reunion tours and reunions with legendary acts and groups. Why
we
wasn't
did
there
have
ever
a Juice Crew reunion tour. We just, if you look it up, you can look it up on the internet. There's a Juice Crew reunion tour. I had to quit that too. I was getting one song during this Juice Crew reunion tour. Okay? They would make me sing the bridge because the promoters didn't want, if y'all don't know my worth, I don't want to even be down. So everybody would get to do what they want, but Shan come out, he got to do the bridge. Like, that's the only song I ever had, or, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
When I got on the phone with y'all, y'all was playing a song that I forgot I had. You know what I'm saying?
Right, right.
So,
right.
People that want to hear that, do I got to just say, oh, just because y'all give me these little crumbs, I'll sing what you want me to sing? I didn't have to do these shows in the first place. Remember, I produced that snow joint. I'm living comfortable. I'm not living glorious and lavish, but I'm living better than a person is. I sleep all day. That's all I do. I sleep all day. Not brab. I'm just saying.
You're retired.
I built
You're
my
living
life.
A retirement
no,
life.
I built my nope. I've always done this my whole entire life. I've never worked a day in my life. I built my life the way that I structured it. You know what I'm saying? It's like I had a dream and I fulfilled that dream. I don't have calluses on my hand. I never did a hard day's work. You can look at my whole resume. I only got 2 weeks of work. Matter of fact, 4 weeks of work in 2 summers, and that was a summer job with my grandfather. From that, I just followed my dreams and figured it out. And it just so happened that at this point in life, it just recircled itself around. Because when you're good to people and you do things for people, you never know how your blessings are going to come back.
There it is.
And that's possible for everybody. I don't never want to hear nobody tell me, oh, I didn't have a father. I didn't have a dude. Oh, the white man held me down. Get the fuck out my face. Nigga, I'm from the projects, nigga, and I do what I do. You just got to find your niche and go for it. End of story.
There it is. There it is. The legendary MC Shan. Hey, Shan, in closing, man, what do you want the people, man, to take from everything we talked about, your career, everything, you know, the knowledge, the history, the education that you tried to give the people tonight and that you did do? What do you want them to take, you know, from the MC Shan legacy, man, that they may not know that
Listen,
they need to know?
I don't know. I don't know what they need to hear. I just speak, and if it speaks to you, then that day I'm speaking to you. If it feels to us, and I'm appealing to somebody else that day, but it's not you, that's the person I'm talking to. I talk to everybody because I'm just as normal as everybody. Some days I'm feeling this. Some days I see this, and I want to talk about that. You know what I'm saying? So I talk to everybody. It just depends on the day that I'm talking to you.
Okay.
That's as simple as I can say it. You know what I'm saying? That's what I want people to do. Some things I said in this interview might apply to some people and the other ones that don't. Good night. So, you know what I mean? But I just want somebody to take something out of it like you did with the Amazon.
Yeah. You gave me some game, homie. You gave me some game, big homie. Yes, sir. Yeah, I did not know that because I got people now that want, you know, CDs.
But
I don't, you know, like I don't want a hard copy.
I'm the dinosaur. 1988 first record came out.
That's why. Nah. You got a lot of history and game, Shan. That's why I wanted you on the show. And I hope everybody got something from this, you know. So that was the point, man. You know, I appreciate you, bro. I appreciate everything you do. You still do. I follow your page, you know, and a lot of people may think
tell everybody else
on
again.
There.
MC
Man,
Shan
follow the homies.
One. MC
Instagram.
Shan one.
Instagram. Go follow right because a lot of people on Instagram right now scrolling down through their page and all that shit. Make sure you go follow the homie MC Shan one right now on Instagram. You know what I mean?
I ain't gonna tell y'all no lie. You're gonna see me talking crap. You're gonna see me just being happy. You're gonna see whatever. You're gonna see me mowing my lawn. Who cares? So what?
Hey, Shan, let me ask you this. I got two questions before we go. Quick. First, I didn't get to touch on this. I played this earlier before you came on the show. but it's one of my favorites, a lot of others' favorites, Left Me Lonely joint, man. Tell us about that joint, how that came about, and you know, the, you know, how do you feel about the reception? Because that was a, back in those days, that was a big joint to this day, and people had a love. That wasn't really a love. That was some G shit. You know what I mean? You told a story, but it was like a love song, and that was a classic, Left Me Lonely. Tell me about that. And then we'll get to that next. But tell me about the Left Me Lonely, please, before we go.
Well,
that's one
Left
of my favorites.
Me Lonely, that was about, look, let me tell you. This is a funny story, and it lasts all the way up to these days, right? So that story was about a chick named Tawana that I used to talk to back in the days, right? And
right.
Then she decided she wanted me to go to the Army so that we could get married. No, I'm not going to motherfucking Army. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So she left me for another nigga that was in the Army.
Okay.
And so I was heartbroken and shit. I was like really the first pussy I was hitting on a regular basis. Excuse me for saying that once again. Right.
Right. Right.
But that motherfucking, here go the song. I had a chance to write a song about it, but I ain't never put no nine to my head. But it just took something in life that people are, you know, that's a commonality with people. People always get their heart broke or whatever.
Right,
you know
right,
what I'm saying?
Right.
You go through shit.
Right.
Although you did, you went through it, there's other people that feel the same shit that you feeling.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
So
right.
That's what that Left Me Lonely was about. Now, here go the controversy with that. You know, I Need Love, LL. Right? Russell Simmons
right.
was paying record companies, radio stations, not to play Left Me Lonely so that they could make it like I Need Love came out first before Left Me Lonely. Like I was copying L. But too late, it came out already, and it never happened that way. Everybody know that Left Me Lonely was the first kind of...
Man, that was the joint right there, man. A lot of people forgot about that one, but go back and do your history, man. Left Me Lonely was the joint, man.
And that was like really the first conceptual video.
It was.
That was
it
the
was.
First video that Ralph McDaniels and
Classic Ralph.
Concept ever did.
Yeah.
Was Left
yep.
Me Lonely. That was their break into the video world. That video right there.
Yep, classic.
But it
man,
helped
that's
a lot going. That I had an ill story for them to tell. You know what I'm saying? So
yeah, yeah, man. Classic. Once again, man. I want to thank you once again, MC Shan, man, for joining the platform, man, and giving us your time and your history and stories, legendary stories. You know, we thank you, man. And once again, please go follow the homie right now, MC Shan One. On Instagram. And you know, we spoke about you quit rapping all that, but is there any way or anything we may have coming in the future? Or they just
oh,
need
yeah,
to go
come
back
on.
And
you know,
to the class.
You know how I do, G Lou. I be
okay,
talking
okay.
crap, yo. Like I said
okay.
a minute ago, I go do the shows for free for the fans. Mm-hmm. If they say, yo, Shan, we got a feel over here, we're gonna set up, I go do it for free for them, but I'm not gonna do it for some crooked ass promoters. Profitable gain, you know what I'm saying, on the name of fucking old school hip hop. I'm not
right.
starving like that, you know what I'm saying. I'm
right.
sorry that my other brother, look, now remember back in the days, there's a movie company called United Artists, right? What
yes,
happened
yes.
back then was that the movie studios were trying to pimp the artists, the movie actors. They said, yo, you know what? Without us, they ain't no y'all. And they went and made their own conglomerate called United Artists. I don't see why the old school couldn't just go together and say, yo, we're going to make our own thing, blah. And this is what it is. You know what I'm saying? United Artists. This, if you mess with one, you're not going to get the others. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And there's a story that I heard recently about that where, yo, the promoter tried to juke a lot of people, and one of the artists was like, yo, he'll take and try and make deals under the table, because the promoter wasn't trying to pay certain artists, but this artist particularly was going to make a deal with the promoter to get his money and screw everybody else who ain't getting paid, and that ain't how we do in the hip-hop game. So I'm pretty sure that person is feeling a wrath right now.
Okay. Okay. All righty. Well, again, Shan, thank you again, man, for coming on the show tonight. It was history made tonight. We thank everybody who tuned in. Anything else we need to let the people know, Shan, or you want to say to the people listening, man, before we check out?
I appreciate y'all for listening. I appreciate those that have been following with me through the years and all of that. Appreciate y'all. Like I said, I'm coming out with a new joint, and it's called The Album That Never Was, because I got so many tapes around that when people were saying Shan fell off, I'm going to show y'all how bad I fell off, and you're going to just look at it and say, yo, he was so much nicer than all of them. No wonder they tried to keep him under the bus.
Right, right. That part. MC Shan, man, fell all off in your motherfucking ass. We got the legendary MC
right.
Shan up in here tonight. Classic episode. Thank you, everybody, who tuned in, man. If you missed the episode, we'll have it back up shortly. Check out the YouTube page, G-Lew Show, the G-Lew Show at Blog Talk Radio. We want to thank MC Shan again. I'm going to bring him back soon again when he drops the new
music. I want to say appreciate my folks on the West Coast that called in. Hey, you know
yes,
what I'm
sir.
Saying?
Rev Ali. And shout out to the homie Jeff Kwan, BTP Media Group, and up in the Bay, man. Made it all happen. Much love, Jeff and BTP. Shout out to Tweed, Cadillac 93. Tweed, FM-ism. And everybody who tuned in tonight, my big homie, Big Shan, man. Much love, brother. I'm going to be in touch with you.
Appreciate you, brother. Yeah. Y'all be good. Appreciate y'all for talking to me. Back to the movie.
Yes, sir.
The movie.
All yes,
right.
Sir.
See your blood. Take care, y'all. All right.
Yeah.
Hey, yo, hold up. We're doing this for the bridge. We don't need that tonight. There's going to be none of that tonight. Yo, we're doing this for the bridge.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got Queens responders up in this motherfucker tonight. They just came from war. They want to let you know a little something about where they come from.
Yo. What's up, Blastmaster KRS-One? This jam is kicking. Word. Yo, what up, D-Nice?
Yo, what's up, Scott LaRock?
Yo, man, we chilling. This funky fresh jam. I want to tell you a little something about us. We're the Boogie Down Production crew. And due to the fact that no one outside there knew what time it was, we have to tell you a little story about where we come from.
South Bronx. The South, South Bronx.
Tell me this style is terrific. It is kind of different, but let's get specific. KRS-One specializes in music. I'll only use this type of style when I choose it. Party people in a place to be. KRS-One attack. You got dropped off MCA because the rhymes you wrote was whack. So you think that hip-hop had its start out in Queensbridge? If you pop that junk up in the Bronx, you might not live. I came with Scott LaRock to express one thing. I am a teacher and others are kings. If that's a title they earn, well, it's well deserved. But without a crown, see, I still burn. You settle for a pebble, not a stone like a rebel. KRS-One is the holder of a boulder, money folder. You want a fresh style? Let me show you. Now, way back in the days when hip-hop began, with Coca, LaRock, Kool Herc, and then bam, these boys ran to the latest jam. But when it got shot up, they went home and said, damn, it's got to be a better way to hear our music every day. People's getting blown away, but coming outside anyway. They tried again outside and see the park. Power from a streetlight made the place dark. But yo, they didn't care. They turned it out. I know a few understand what I'm talking about. Remember, Bronx River, Rolling Six, with cool DJ Red Alert and Chuck Chill Out on the mix. When Africa Islam was rocking the jams, and on the other side of town was a kid named Flash. Patterson and Millbrook Projects, Casanova all over, you couldn't stop it. The Nine Lives crew, the Cypress boys, the real rock steady taking out these toys. As odd as it looked, as Wallace and seen, I didn't hear a peep from a place called Queens. It was 76 to 1980, the dregs in Brooklyn was crazy. You couldn't bring out your set with no hip-hop because the pistols would go. So why don't you wise up, show off the people in the place that you are whack? Instead of trying to take out LL, you need to take your homeboys off the crack. Cause if you don't, well then nerds will become shot. And that would leave the job up to my own Scott LaRock. And he's from
South Bronx.
Hey man, hold on. I didn't mean to do all that. Shout out to KRS-One, man. Shout out to MC Shan. Legendary hip hop right there. Shout out to Queensbridge. Shout out to the South Bronx. Shout out to everybody who tuned in tonight. It's the G-Lew Show. Flashback Fridays. My special guest, MC Shan. Live on the premises, man. We did it again. Another classic episode. You dig? I'm going to just rock out for a minute, man. Much love to everybody. Hey, Pam. What's up, baby?
Just did.
Call this bitch.
He said he thinks...
Hello.
What's up?
Nothing. What you doing?
Man, I'm just kicking it.
Are y'all done?
Thank you. Nah, what you gonna do today?
For
destroying that
letter. Take out my clothes
for the
clean. I ain't gonna get my nails done.
Yeah. Where?
Why, what's up?
Hey, did what's your name get at you yesterday?
Who?
These nuts.
Oh, shut up, nigga.
But I wanna ask you one question. If I had some nuts hanging on the walls, what the hell, honey? I'm just a darling, you have some walnuts. She said, well, Daddy, if I had some nuts on my chest, would those be chestnuts? I said, hell yeah. She said, well, Daddy, if I had nuts under my chin, would those be chin nuts? I said, hell no, bitch, you'd have a dick in your mouth.
Chicky check, microphone check, one.
Chicky check, microphone check, two.
Chicky check, microphone check, three.
Check game from the notorious Compton G.
Back with some shit that got the bump. As you pull up in the park, your pops is drunk. Just a fucker like a motherfucker clowning and shit. Got your dangers on your hoopty and your fly ass bitch. Throw off, I'll take that home. If she proper, I'ma pop up, I hold hop up. It's back on track. with big money, big nuts, and a big fat chronic stack.
So jazz, step up on they ass and give these motherfuckers a blast from the past.
Digging these dabs out of the cut with some shit that I wrote with my nigga D.R.E. So you know I must be dope, but rat tat 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 that ass. Starting static with Drake, make way for the AK. That I grind, guys, I slang like Cappy. Not from Crisscross, but they call me Mac Daddy. Hattie, not known about the city I'm from. Long Beach, Tic Tac, grab your gap, watch your back, here I come. Stomping in my khaki suit. Big G from the hood, Ken from Eastwood. God damn, I ripped up, picked up, and skipped up on top of things as they swing towards my ding-a-ling.
Look, could you raise up off his nuts? Cause Dr. Drizzy's about to rizz that shit up. Cheeky check.
Microphone check. One.
Cheeky check.
Microphone check. Two.
Cheeky check.
Microphone check. Three.
You're tuned to the sounds of the DRE.
Now check me out. It's back to the old school. Where the niggas get they strap on. Don't nobody cap on. Slap on some DRE. On some funky ass shit by the D-O-G-Y-D-O-G. Real G's who drop keys. Protect D's. N-U-T. So nigga, please. Keep out my manuscript. You see that it's a mother drop gangsta shit.
Yeah.
So recognize gang from the gangsta. Things will remain the same until I change them.
It's real easy to see. So you can check sounds from Nate D O Double G.
I can't be faded. I'm a nigga from the motherfucking street. I can't be faded. I'm a nigga from the motherfucking street. I can't be faded. I'm a nigga from the motherfucking street. I can't be played. I'm a nigga from the motherfucking street. I heard you wanna fuck with Dre. You picked the wrong motherfucking day. Here we go, toe to toe, blow for blow. Let me know if you think you can fake that, bro. I heard you wanna fuck with Dre. You picked the wrong motherfucking day. Here we go, toe to toe, blow for blow. Let me know if you think you can fake that, bro.
Put your hands in the air with your mouth shut. she loking for a G. We want your hands in the air with your mouth shut.
With her, she loke on the mic.
It won't be G, it's on the cup.
We make your heart beat.
With her, she loking for a G.
I got Ruby like Drake, more like Trump, like the homie Tracy T, who the quickest to dump. Follow me, back to the situation at hand. We make it hard, beat, bounce, with your hands on your chest and your pants. Open, I'm scoping, the homie straight loking. Break, we go for broken. What you smoking? The bomb blueberry, Jeezy, Weezy's back, and it's scary to each and every one of you on the beats. You want none of these, we rap catastrophes, make your heart beat. Her, she loke on the mic.
It won't be G, it's on the cup.
We make your heart beat.
With her, she loking for a G. We want your hands in the air with your mouth shut.
With her, she loke on the mic.
It won't be G, it's on the cup.
We make your heart beat.
With her, she loking for a G. We want your hands in the air with your mouth shut.
With her, she loke on the mic.
It won't be G, it's on the cup.
We make your heart beat.
With her, she loking for a G. We want your hands in the air with your mouth shut.
With her, she loke on the mic.
It won't be G, it's on the cup.
We make your heart beat. With her, she loke and Warren G.
Sunday, that's when we load.